So, good afternoon, students. Today, we are going to discuss some of the topics in the Module 3, that is Business Intelligent Concepts and Application and Data Mining. Okay. So, as you all know, in the present world, or the present world is dominated by data, right? It's more important than ever for business to understand how to extract every drop of value from the raft of digital insights available at their fingerprints. So, there is one saying here that from Geoffrey Moore, who is a management consultant and author, he says that without big data, you are blind and deaf and in the middle of a freeway. Okay, so with these words, we can say that above 85% of business leaders feel that using big data to their advantage will significantly improve the way they run their organization or a company. So by gaining the ability to understand which data sets are relevant to particular goals, strategies and initiatives in the organization, we will be able to identify the trends or patterns that will help us to make a significant improvements in the number of key areas within the organization. This concept is known as a business intelligence. Okay, so business intelligence, or in short we call it as a BI, okay, is becoming increasingly prevalent across industry every year. Business intelligent concepts refer to the usage of digital computing technologies in the form of data, warehouses, analytics, and visualization with the aim of identifying and analyzing essential business-based data to generate new actionable corporate insights. BI technologies offer present, that is real-time, historical and predictive views of internally structured data relating to all departments within an organization, which exponentially enhances operational insights and improve the decision-making process of the organization. So, to put in the simple word, what is business intelligence? Business intelligence is the process of discovering valuable trends of patterns, or in other words, we can call it as a knowledge. Okay, so trends of patterns or knowledge in data to make more efficient, accurate decision related to the business goals of an organization. Okay, related to our business goals or aims and strategies of the organization. Like this we can define. So, business intelligence include variety of IT applications that are used to analyze an organization data and communicate the information to relevant user. So, if you see here, this diagram shows that this is one cyclic process. Business needs data. So, from data, if you use the mining technology, mining algorithm, if you mine the data, we'll get the knowledge that we call it as intelligence. So that intelligence is required to improve the business of the organization. Yes or no? So all this together is a basic idea of business intelligence. Next, we discuss there are different types of decision types. Okay, there are basically two types of decision type. One is strategic decision, another is operational decision. What is this strategic decision? Strategic decision are those that impact the direction of the company. Okay, direction of the company. The decision to reach out to a new customer set could be a strategic decision. Reaching to a customer is a strategic decision. Okay, so in strategic decision making, the goal itself may or may not be clear. Okay, the goal or a goal may or may not be clear. So business intelligence or BI can help to create new ideas based on new patterns found from the data mining techniques. Okay, so next is, what is operational decision? Operational decision are more routine and tactical decision. Okay, more routine and tactical decision focused on developing greater efficiency. Okay, like updating an old websites with new features will be an operational decision. Okay, because day by day the trend changes. Yes or no? So the day by day the needs of the customer changes. So likewise, it should be up to date. So for that, the new to accommodate the new demands, okay, it need to be changed. So that type of decision we call it as an operational decision. So operational decision can be made more efficient using an analysis of past data. Okay, we can do the operational decision using an analysis of past data. In a machine learning, you would have learned about the classification, supervised learning. Yes or no? So a classification system can be created and modeled using a data of a past instances to develop a good model of the domain. So this model can help improve the operational decisions in the future. That means we have a historical data, right? So based on this historical data, you can make a decision. Okay, you can make a decision or you can predict. Okay, you can take the decisions. Such things we call it as a operational data. So business intelligence can help automate operational level of decision making, and it will improve efficiency by making millions of micro level operational decision in the model driven way. Okay, in the model driven way, say for example, a bank might want to make a decision about making financial loans, okay, in a more scientific way using data based models. So here in this case, a decision tree model is what? It is a classification model, right? It is a classification model. So decision tree model can provide consistently accurate loan decision. Okay, so developing such decision tree models is one of the main application of data mining techniques. So next we move on to
You are now unmuted.
Okay, next we move on to business tools. Yeah, BI tools or business intelligent tools. Business intelligence includes a variety of software tools and techniques. Okay, to provide the managers with the information and insights needed to run the business. So here, BI tools include data warehousing, online analytical processing, social media analytics, reporting, dashboard, querying, and data mining. Okay, it includes many things. So BI tools can range from very simple tools to a sophisticated tools. Okay, so when I say simple tools, that could be considered like end user tools, like MS Excel, simple. Okay, so to very sophisticated tools that offer a very broad and complex set of functionalities. It will be basically for the high end level. Okay, so simple means for the end user. Simple tools mean for the end user. It will be at the level of the end user. Okay, that means common man. Okay, sophisticated means it is for the developers, analysts, for them, for executives, okay, for the experts, for them. So now here we have some of the BI tools I have written here. So we have a spreadsheet tool, we have a dashboard system, and we have a data mining system. So spreadsheet tool such as Microsoft Excel can act as an easy but effective BI tool by itself. We say just MS Excel, what MS Excel, only for the data storage, yes, obviously. But still it can act as a efficient, okay, tool for the BI, business intelligence. Data can be downloaded and stored in the spreadsheet, then analyzed to produce insights and can be presented in the form of graphs and tables, okay. So this systems, that is MS Excel, offers limited automation using macros and other features. So there are n number of features, okay. The analytical features include basic statistical and financial function. So there are one more option like pivot tables, which help to do sophisticated what if analysis. Okay, what if analysis. So there are add-on modules can be installed to enable moderately sophisticated statistical analysis. So this type of tool we call it as a spreadsheet tool. Next we have a dashboard system. So dashboard system such as IBM Cognos or Tableau. Most of you would have done the course in the Tableau, right? So Tableau. So this tools can offer a sophisticated set of tools for gathering the data, analyzing the data, and presenting the data to the end user. So at the user end, okay, at the user end, modular dashboard can be designed and redesigned easily, okay, with the graphical user interface. That I'll show you in the next slide. We have one example. I have one example I put. So the backend data, okay, this is for a graphical user interface at a front end. The backend data and backend data analytical capabilities include many statistical functions. So the dashboards are linked to data warehouse, okay, at the backend to ensure that the tables and graphs and other elements of the dashboards are updated in real time, which I am showing in the next slide. Okay, so I'll show you that. Yeah, you can see this. This is a one simple dashboard of IBM Cognos. Okay, so you can see the data is represented in the form of a pattern, or the information is represented in the form of a graph. Okay, all this, which is visualization, will be made very easier. Analysis of data will be made very easier. So next one more we have, that is data mining system. What this data mining system, such as IBM SPSS modeler, okay, are industrial strength system that provides capabilities to apply a wide range of analytical models, okay, on a large data set. This is for SPSS modeler. And we have another type of tool, that is Weka tool. It is very common popular tool, Weka. So Weka are popular platform designed to help to mine the large amount of data to discover the interesting patterns. Okay, Weka tool can be used to discover the interesting patterns. So you can see some of the tools, okay, which is available. I just put the pick of it. Okay, so this is the example of IBM Cognos dashboard. Next, we move on to some BI applications, business intelligence applications. So BI tools are required in almost all industries and functions. Yes or no? So the nature of the information and the speed of action may be different across the business. But every manager today need access to BI tools to have up-to-date metrics about business performance. Okay, everyone, the business nature may vary. Okay, it can be a banking system, it can be a healthcare system. Okay, it can be a any retail system, anything, but it may vary from application to application. But every application need the help of business intelligence. So here I have taken few, the business intelligence applications are many. Okay, in the education it is there, retail it is there, insurance it is there, okay, government it is there. So many applications are there, in so many fields BI applications are there. So I'm just taking one or two to discuss here. Okay, so let us consider the first application, that is customer relationship management. Okay, how well we can satisfy, okay, how well we can keep the customer happy, okay, happy, so that our business will be running good. So customer relationship management, here a business exists to serve the customer, yes or no? The customer is the main point in the business. So a happy customer becomes a repeat customer, yes or no? Once the customer is happy, he or she likes to buy the product or the items again and again from the same organization, right, or the company. So a business should understand the needs and sentiments of the customer. Not only needs, the sentiment of the customer also. Okay, so sentiments of the customer, and also sell more of its offering to the existing customer, and also expand the pool of the customer it serves. So BI application can impact many aspects of marketing. So first one is maximize the return on marketing campaigns. Okay, maximize the return on marketing campaigns. So what is actually this here? It is basically the understanding the customer's pain points from data-based analysis. Okay, can ensure that the marketing messages are fine-tuned to better serve the customer. Okay, next, improve customer retention. Okay, improve customer retention. Another word we call it as a churn analysis. Okay, improve customer retention. That means what? We are not going to lose the customer. So we are making the customer who buys once, okay, will come always. Okay, again and again the customer will be there, or the customer will be there for a long time. Okay, that we call it as a churn analysis. So it is more difficult and expensive to win the new customer than it is to retain existing customer. So scoring each customer on their likelihood to quit can help the business design effective interventions such as discounts or free service to retain profitable customer, okay, in a cost effective manner. So next we have maximize customer value. Okay, that we called as cross selling or upselling. Okay, it is hyphen here, cross selling or upselling. So every contact with the customer should be seen as an opportunity to gain their current needs. Yes or no? That is very, very important. So once the customer comes, goes, we should not. Every customer should be treated as a VIPs. So offering a customer new products and solutions based on those imputed needs can help increase revenue per customer. That's what we do in the association rule, no? So buying pattern, based on the buying pattern, the customer will be given the discount and all, so that the customer, that the intention to keep the customer happy, yes or no? So even a customer complaint can be seen as an opportunity to wow the customer. Okay, using the knowledge of the customer's history, buying pattern, okay, okay, and the value, the business can choose to sell the premium services to the customer. That will be happening in the supermarkets and any mobile shop, anything. So always they will be watching the customer very keenly, their buying pattern, their history of how what product they like more, what is their range of buying the product. All this they will be keep on working on. Yes or no? Okay. So next is the identification of highly valued customer. Okay, identification of highly valued customer. That means what? Which customer? Means there will be a varieties of customer. Yes or no? When I say variety of customer, some customer will come weekly once, some customer will come daily once, some customer will go and buy monthly once. So, and some customer like to buy expensive things. Some customer may like to buy only a few things. Okay. Like that. There will be a very buying patterns. Okay. Buying ways. So by segmenting the customers, the best customers can be identified. Okay. They can be proactively contacted. Okay, you can see in the mobile and all, you will be getting the messages and all. So, telling about the offers and all. Okay, so that may increase the customer to come and buy the products. So, indirectly, it will be improving the business. Okay, and delighting with greater attention and better services. All these are nothing but a highly valued identification of highly valued customer. So, next one is manage brand image. That is very, very important and challenging one. Yes or no? Okay, brand image. So brand image means what? Once the organization or the brand gets that image, it should not be fall. Okay, should not fall. So a business can create a listening post to listen to the social media chatter about itself. It can then do sentimental analysis of the text to understand the nature of comments and respond appropriately to the prospects and customer. So manage brand image. So it should always keep that fame. Okay, keep that fame. So how it can keep that fame? By always satisfying the customers. So these are the some of the area. This is one of the area the business intelligent applied. So next we move on to another application. Okay, another application I have taken is banking. Okay, so we all are aware of the banking system, right? Okay, so here banks make loans and offer credit cards to millions of customers. Yes or no? Daily basis, you or me, everyone will be getting, yeah, you are eligible for a credit card, or you are eligible for a loan. Okay, HDFC is very glad to give you the loan. All this calls will be coming. Okay, so they are most interested in improving the quality of loans and reducing bad debts. So they also want to retain more good customers and sell more services to them. So here, how the banking system can be improved? By using a business intelligent techniques. Okay, so here business intelligent means what? We have a data. Okay, so we have to select or extract the interesting pattern from the existing data. That means what is waste for other person may be useful for me. Okay, so we have to extract the important data that actually improves the business. Okay, that means the data are available, so we have to use some strategies so that from data we will get a profit. Okay, so that intelligence we called as a business intelligence. So here in the banking system, so to improve the business intelligence can be used to say make some decisions. Okay, like automate the loan application process. Instead of doing manually, automate the loan application process. That means what? Here to do that automation, the decisions module can be generated. Yes or no? decision models like decision tree induction, okay, rule based classifier, all this decision models can be generated from past or historical data that predicts the likelihood of a loan proving successful. This can be interested in business processes to automate the financial loan approval process. Okay, so we no need to go back of, okay, back of the customer. So it is automated loan application process based on the customer history. Okay, the way the customer has maintained the CIBIL code, all this based on that, the loan process can be automated. So next is detect fraudulent transaction. That is very, very important, right? Okay, because banking system is, it should be very, 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 okay, secured. It should be very, very secure. So detecting the fraudulent transaction, here we can apply the intelligent techniques. Okay, so here billions of financial transaction will be happening around the world every day. Yes or no? Okay, so as Corona has come, so everything is online now. Okay, everything is done. The online has become more demand than before. Yes or no? So everyone want to do online. So so social distancing will be maintained. So here billions of financial transactions will be happening every day around the world, right? So exception seeking models can identify patterns of fraudulent transaction. Okay, we can use the exception seeking models. Say for example, if money is being transferred to an unrelated account for the first time, it could be a fraudulent transaction. So what you will do in such, suppose in such case, so if you transfer a amount to a first time, if you are transferring to the amount to a new account number, then immediately you will get the message saying that if are you initiated this transaction. If you are not initiated, please contact the bank. Yes or no? Okay, all this is very, very important. So that message may alert the customer if he is not done the transaction. Okay, so next we have the maximize customer value. So here also we call it as cross selling or upselling. Okay, maximize customer value. Selling more products and services to existing customer is often the easiest way to increase the revenue. Yes or no? Instead of going on searching the new customer, for the existing customer only a new offers, okay, loans, if there it is given, okay, interest rate is increased like that. If the existing customer is delighted, obviously the customer will be more supportive. Okay, so they may not move on to the other banks or other any financial organization. So a checking account customer, okay, in good standing could be offered home or auto or educational loans on more favorable terms than other customers, and thus the value generated from the customer could be increased. Okay, next we have the optimized cash reserves with forecasting. So what is this? Banks have to maintain certain liquidity to meet the needs of depositors who may like to withdraw money. Yes or no? Okay, using past data and trends analysis, bank can forecast how much to keep and invest the rest of the earned interest. Okay, so this is some of the two application I discussed where the BI applications can be used. Okay, they're in many areas. It can be used in financial service, it can be used in insurance forecasting, public sector, okay, like government gathers a large amount of data by virtue, okay, of their regulatory functions. So now the government is accumulating the data with respect to COVID-19, yes or no, coronavirus. So they are making which area is in red zone, which area is in orange zone or green zone, and based on that they are taking the decisions. Okay, so all this is having a influence of business intelligence. Okay, so this is about the business intelligence application. So next, we move on to another topic called data mining.
You are now muted. You are now unmuted.
So we will discuss about some of the topics in the data mining. Okay. So what actually data mining? Data is nothing but the current world is based on the data. It is driven by the data. So the process of extracting the interesting patterns from a large data set we called as a data mining. So here, it is a process of discovering knowledge, insights, and patterns in the data. So when I say pattern, pattern is nothing but a knowledge. Okay. So patterns must be valid, novel, it should be potentially useful and understandable. Okay. All these properties should be there in the pattern which is extracted from the raw data. Okay. That is valid. It should be valid, potentially useful, novel, and understandable. So data mining is a multidisciplinary field. Okay. When I say multidisciplinary field, it has the support of machine learning, pattern recognition, statistics, okay, artificial intelligence, yes or no? So many fields are interconnected. Okay, artificial intelligence, machine learning, pattern recognition. Okay, all these are interconnected. So like data mining, it borrows techniques from varieties of field. As I told, artificial intelligence, it utilizes the knowledge of data quality and data organizing from the database area. That is, we are discussed database. Okay, database area. It draws modeling and analytical techniques from statistics and computer science, that is artificial intelligence area. It also draws the knowledge of decision making from the field of business management. So that's why MBA people also will be working on business intelligence. Okay, MBA also. So they will be working on the managerial level or the business level. So these are the fields. Okay, it also uses the pattern recognition. Okay. Such as to identify the patterns. Okay, like this, it is a multidisciplinary field. So here, for gathering and selecting the proper data, okay, many organizations develop a model called enterprise data model. Okay, in order to organize the data. Okay, so to mine the data. Okay. So, in order to mine the data, first the data need to be collected. Yes or no? It should be collected. Okay. The data need to be gathered and selected. Okay. So, if you take the social media, if you take the like Facebook, Twitter, okay, WhatsApp. So, if you take the social media, so we have millions or trillions of terabytes of exabytes of data available. Okay, data available. So from this, okay, data is available now. Okay, but we need to gather and select the data which is important and which will improve our business or a company. That is very challenging. Yes or no? If you take a Jio, okay, if you take a Reliance, okay, they will be keep on searching, okay, where I get the opportunity so that I can grow there. Yes or no? Okay, like that. So here, first we have to gather the data. So when I gather the data should be suitable for me, okay, suitable to my work, okay, or my business. So we should first gather the data, and after gathering the data, we have to select the data which actually suits my work, okay. That is very, very important. So here we have PDM model. So to learn from data, quality data needs to be effectively gathered, cleaned and organized, and then efficiently mined. Yes or no? Okay, first it need to be gathered, cleaned and organized, okay, and then efficiently mined. So that's why to do all this, there is a model called EDM model, enterprise data model, which is used to organize the data in a proper format. And EDM is a unified high level model of all the data stored in an organization databases. Okay, the EDM is usually inclusive of the data generated from all internal systems. So it provides the basic menu of data to create a data warehouse for a particular decision making purpose. Okay, so we have data warehouse, which help to organize all this data in an easy and usable manner so that it can be selected and deployed for mining. So first we have to gather the data. So when we gather the data, we need some medium to store it. Where we'll store? We'll store in the data warehouse. Okay, so in the data warehouse, we collect or gather the data from multiple sources. Multiple sources means what? It can be from the file, it can be from the operational database, okay, it can be from external sources. So it will be from many sources, okay. So you would have heard about data warehouse, yes or no? So data warehouse is nothing but it is a storage basically, okay. What it will store? It will store the data from different resources, okay. When I say different resources, the data can be gathered from the operational database, okay, which will be stored in the form of Oracle, using Oracle or MySQL or MS, Microsoft SQL Server, like that many different tools may be used or the software may be used, and the data may be stored in a simple Excel file, or the data may be stored in a document file, okay, spreadsheet, like that, okay. So data from warehouse, in the data warehouse, the data will be gathered from multiple sources. We are gathering the data from multiple sources. When we gathering the data from multiple sources, one more thing we have to keep in mind, that the data can be of different format. Yes or no? The date format which is in the Oracle is not same as a date format in the the date format in the MySQL. Yes or no? That simple thing only we'll take. Okay. So here, this I was just checking the one doubt asked by student. Okay. I'll answer you at the end. Okay. What I was telling. So this EDM model. Okay. So data warehouse helps to organize all the data which is collected from the multiple resources. Okay, multiple resources. So the EDM, that is enterprise data model, okay, can also help imagine what relevant external data should be gathered to provide the context and develop good predictive relationship with the internal data. Okay, so gathering and selecting is a very, very important process in data mining. Next is another very, very important step in data mining, that is data cleaning and preparation. Okay, data cleaning and or cleansing and preparation. So why we need to cleanse the data and we need to prepare the data? So we call it as ETL, okay, extract, load, transform, like that. So why we need to cleanse the data? Because we need a quality data. Okay, we need a quality data. Yes or no? The good quality, good result, or good output we will get. In machine learning, you would have studied this, right? The quality of data is critical to the success and value of data mining project. Okay, otherwise the situation will be like the kind of garbage in and garbage out. In short, we call it as GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. Okay, the quality of incoming data varies by the source and the nature of the data. As I told, we may collect the data from different sources. Different sources that I told, it can be from the databases. The databases can be maintained in the by the Oracle or MySQL. Like that, we have different sources. The data may be collected from the simple files. Okay, all these things. So the quality of incoming data varies by the source and nature of data. Data from internal operations is likely to be higher quality, okay, as it will be accurate and consistent. Okay, data from the social media like Facebook, Twitter and other public sources is less accurate as it is under the control of business and is likely to be reliable. Okay, so how we can make the, there are some ways to clean the data, like filling missing values, okay, then transforming fields, binning continuous variables, so on so. So data cleansing and preparation is a labor intensive or semi-automated activity that can take up to 60 to 80% of the time needed to data mining process. Okay, you should be very, very clear about it. Okay, in the data mining process, the first process is data collection. Yes or no? Once the data is collected, the data need to be cleaned and prepared. Okay, so that we called as a data pre-processing. You would have heard about all these terms, I think. Okay, data pre-processing. So data pre-processing is a very, very important step. If the pre-processing is not done, okay, if we are not getting the data which is required and which is of good quality, okay, then we may not get the result what we are expecting. Yes or no? Okay, a simple thing I'll tell you. So if you are preparing a curry, okay, if you prepare a curry with the rotten, okay, vegetables, what will be the quality of a curry? Yes or no? So what is that? That means if you are putting quality ingredients, okay, good quality dal, fresh vegetables, okay, fresh masala powder, all this, if you are using and preparing a curry, it is 100% the curry will be tasty with appropriate measure of ingredients. Yes or no? Condition applied. Okay. So, but if you, in the other case, if you are not putting a quality ingredients, okay, if you are not putting a quality ingredients, what will be the final result? Anyone can text me. Okay. What will be the final result? The final result will not be, the curry will not be tasty. Yes or no? The final result is curry is not tasty. Same thing here also. Data mining processes. The first and foremost thing is that the data preparation should be correct. So that's why 60 to 80% of the time is needed or consumed for the data cleansing and preparation. Or in short, we can call it as data preparation. Okay, pre-preparation. So there are some methods. Okay, there are some activities that can be done in the data cleaning and preparation. So all the, what are that? So duplicate data needs to be removed. The data which is repeating again and again. Okay, so no value of that. Okay, so one copy is enough. Okay, no need of keeping multiple copies. So in that case, we can remove that. The same data may be received from multiple sources. Okay, when merging the data set may be deduplicated. That means the duplicate data need to be removed. So So this is done in the cleansing and preparation. So now missing value need to be filled in. There will be some data missing. Okay. So say for example, when we are collecting the customer information, okay, the customer may not fill in the application, the age, okay, or the gender or the any other values. Okay. So in that case, that thing we called as a missing values. Okay. That column will be empty. Okay. The column will be empty. So we have to fill it up. Okay. We have to handle this missing values. So missing values can be filled in with, okay, in with average or model or default values, or those rows should be removed from the analysis. This is the way we can handle the missing values. Data elements should be comparable. Okay, data elements. Next is data elements should be comparable. Comparable means what? Data elements may need to be first case that transfer from one unit to another. Say for example, total cost of the healthcare and the total number of patient may need to be reduced to cost patient to allow the comparability of the value. Okay. So they may also need to be adjusted to make them. Okay. To make them. So next, another measure is that comparable over time. Okay. So first thing is data elements may need to be transfer from one unit to another. Data elements may need to be comparable over time. Okay, over time. Say for example, currency value need to be adjusted for inflation. Yes or no? It requests to be converted at the same base year for the comparability. Yes or no? The dollar value may go up, come down, like that. It should be always, okay, comparable. So also it may require to convert to a common currencies, and the data elements may need to be stored at same granularity to ensure comparability. Say for example, sales data may be available daily, but the salesperson compensation data may not only be available monthly. Sales data is available daily, but salesperson compensation data may only available monthly. Is petrol charge or salary, all this, okay, all this done only in the monthly basis, but every day the data will be available. Say such things we called as data element should be comparable. So now next is continuous value. Okay, continuous value may need to be bin. So we know that we have different types of attributes, yes or no? So we have a continuous value, discrete value, okay? Continuous value, discrete value, okay? So continuous value. So into a new few buckets to help with some analysis, like work experience can be binned as a low, medium, high, okay? It can be binned as a low, medium, high. Then next we have outliers. So this is very, very important that we need to be handled in the data mining process. So outliers data elements need to be removed. Outliers data elements need to be removed means what? What is outliers? Outliers are nothing but noise, in other words we say. So noise. Noise means usually the data elements, okay, that is acting differently compared to the other data elements. So on. Okay. Acting differently. Acting differently means for the characteristics. Okay. So customer will be there. Out of customer, there will be a fraudulent customer. The fraudulent customer is the outlier. That means what? The way of behavior, taking the amount from the fraudulent behavior is the outlier. Why? Because, okay. Why? Because normally the transaction will be happening daytime. Yes or no? The fraudulent, it will be during the night time, or it may be continuously, okay, very oftenly will be done like that. So such behavior, the such data elements, we call it as a outliers. So outliers need to be removed from the data or the data set. So this is very much. These are the some of the way we can clean the data or pre-process the data. Is it clear? Next, we move on to data mining techniques. Okay, I will not go into the details because all this you are aware of it. Okay, we have discussed in the details as a big topic in the module 4, module 5, all the 6. So here I just tell you the gist of the data mining techniques. Basically, data mining techniques are two types. One is supervised technique, another is supervised learning, another is unsupervised learning. Yes or no? Okay. Supervised learning means what? We will be building a model and we'll train it and we'll give the test data to check whether the model will predict the test data to a proper class or not. So here in the supervised learning, there will be class label. Whereas in, and it is basically used for prediction. Yes or no? So predictive ability based on the past data. So that is supervised learning. So unsupervised learning means what? It is exploratory analysis to discover the pattern. That means what? We are not guiding or training the model. We are just left the model to learn by itself. Yes or no? We are just left the model. You go and you learn by yourself based on your experience. Okay? Based on your ups and downs. Like that, that is unsupervised learning. So under supervised learning, we have a classification. Yes or no? Classification. So in a, under classification, we have so many other techniques, algorithms, that is decision tree, neural network, regression. Yes or no? Okay. Regression, all these things. So supervised learning, it has having classification and statistics. Okay. So classification, we have a classifier, different types of classifier like decision tree. Okay, tree like model will build. Artificial neural network, it is basically based on the neurons, and regression. Okay, so stock marketing and all will be based on the regression. So this are the some of the techniques which comes under the supervised learning. So unsupervised learning, clustering, that is grouping, cluster analysis, association rule, which will be used for market basket analysis. Hope you remember all this. Cluster analysis, we discussed k-means, okay, k-means technique. In the association rule, we discussed a priori technique, okay, which is basically used to mine the buying pattern of the customer. So, buying pattern of the customer. So, all these are some of the data mining techniques. Yeah, this is very, very important. I'll just take this, okay. So, CRISP. Data mining cycle, CRISP DM. CRISP DM is, it is data mining cycle. So what is this? Very, very important. So it is a what CRISP DM stands for. CRISP DM stands for Cross Industry Standard Process for Data Mining. Okay, it has six essential step. Okay, six essential steps. First one is business understanding. Here you may see, yeah, this one. First step is business understanding. Okay, what this business understanding? The first and most important step in data mining is asking the right business questions. A question is a good one if answering it could lead to a large payoff for the organization, financial and otherwise. Okay, that means in other words, if I say selecting a data mining project is like any other project in that, okay, in that it should show strong payoff if the project is successful. Okay, so there should be strong executive support for data mining project, which means that the project aligns well with the business strategy. The next step we have is data understanding. So business understanding, business, first we have to understand what actually the business, what is the purpose of business, yes or no? Once the business is understood, then we have to move on to the data understanding, what actually we have to do in the business. So a related important step is to understand the data available for mining. We have to understand the data. Yes or no? That is very, very important. So if you buy any system or any, say for example, I bought a new mobile. Yes or no? First, I should understand how I have to use this mobile. I'll go through the manual. I'll know what all app are there, how I can manage the, how I can use efficiently the device. Yes or no? Instruction manual. Similarly, so before we mine, first we need to understand the data properly. Okay. So some imagination and all need not to be done. Okay. Next, what we have to do, data preparation. So long we discussed about what is data preparation. Yes or no? That the data should be relevant, clean and high quality. Okay. That is data preparation. Next, modeling. Modeling is means what? This is the actual task of running many algorithms using the available data to discover if the hypotheses are supported or not. So here we have a modeling. Modeling means what? We can use any data mining techniques, okay, based on the data, okay, data. So based on the applications. So all technique cannot be applied to data, okay, or the application. The data mining techniques, okay, that whether it can be a classification or it can be a clustering or it can be an association rule, okay. So based on the data underlying, we have to use the technique. Say for example, if you are talking about a supermarket data, then we have to find out the buying pattern of the customer, the relationship among the items or the products. If the customer buys milk, the customer is also customer, 70% of the chance is that the customer also buys butter or a customer also buys the bread, okay, like that. So we have to find the relationship among the item. Then we have to go for an unsupervised technique, that is association rule mining. Here we cannot use clustering. Here we have to use association rule mining. Okay, that is very, very, to know that it is very, very important. Okay, that is about the modeling. Okay, next, model evaluation. So once we have constructed the model, it is very, very important that we have to check whether the model is a proper model or not. Is it up to our expectation? That's what we are doing in the testing. Yes or no? So this is about the testing. Okay, so model evaluation. Okay, so accept the data and it should be able to give the good results. Okay, so that we are just evaluating whether the model is a correct model or not. Then last one is, okay, dissemination and rollout. Okay, last one is dissemination and rollout. It is important that the data mining solution is presented to the key stakeholders, okay, key stakeholders, and is deployed in the organization. Otherwise the project will be waste of time and the setback for establishing and supporting the data-based decision process culture in the organization. The model should be eventually embedded in the organization's business processes. So whatever you built, okay, you are built with a lot of effort and taking so much of time. Okay. So much of the company or the organization would have spent, okay, that manual work, or it can be a finance or anything based on that, okay, manpower, finance, all that using, okay, they would have constructed the or built a model. If it is not useful and if it is not up to the satisfaction of the customer, then it will be going vain. Yes or no? That should not happen. That should be taken care of. Okay. So that is final is, that is in software engineering term, if I say maintenance. Okay. Maintenance, customer acceptance. Okay. Or the customer means what? Company. Company acceptance and the maintenance. That is coming here. This is about the model. So, sorry. So next, finally, I just wanted to tell you that evaluating data mining results. So to evaluate the data mining result, I am taken the classification technique, evaluating the supervised learning, okay, technique, that is to do the predictive analysis. Okay, we have a matrix that is called predictive accuracy. Okay, so how we just check the model is correct or a right model or not? By using a predictive accuracy, that is correct prediction divided by total prediction. that is done using a confusion matrix. Yes or no? That is done using a confusion matrix. What this confusion matrix will be having a two different classes, that is true class and predicted class. Yes or no? Then positive negative will be there both. So TP means true positive, FP means false positive, FN means false negative, and TN means true negative. So all this you would have learned in machine learning. I don't need to go in detail here. I think so. Okay. So to evaluate the classification model, okay, we have a equation like this. Predictive accuracy is equal to TP plus TN whole divided by TP plus TN plus FP plus FN. So TP means true positive, TN means true negative, FP means false positive, and FN means false negative. So one case I'll tell here. So true positive. True positive means what? The actual result is also positive and predicted result is also positive. So both are positive, true positive. Negative, true negative means what? True negative means what? True negative. True negative means actual is also negative. Predicted is also negative. Then this one, false positive means what? Actual it is negative, but the model is predicting it as positive. So that is false positive. It is wrong prediction. Okay. So this is the evolution of data mining results. Then next we have data mining tools. Okay. Data mining tools. Okay, so these are the some of the comparison of data mining tools. We have a simple data mining tool, as I told, Excel. Then the sophisticated data mining tools like IBM SPS Modeler and the Weka. Okay, so these are the some of the data mining tools. So here in the data mining tools, if I say that this comparison, you can see here as well. Okay, there are simple end user data mining tools such as MS Excel, and there are more sophisticated tools such as IBM SPS Modeler. Okay, so they are standalone tools. There are standalone tools and also those that are embedded in the existing processing or data warehousing or ERP system. Okay, there is an open source and freely available tools such as Weka, okay, and other commercial products. So there are text-based tools that require some programming skills. Okay, they are GUI-based drag-and-drop format tools. Okay, then data formats. There are tools that work only on proprietary data formats, and there are those that directly accept data from the host of popular data mining or data management tools format. Okay, so there are different platforms. MX Excel is relatively simple and easy data mining tool. Okay. It can get quite versatile once analyst pack and some other add-on products are installed to it. Okay. Weka is an open source GUI based tool that offers large number of data mining algorithms. Then we have here R. Here it is not mentioned. We will be aware of that R, right? R is an extensive and extensible versatile open source statistical programming language. Okay. Which is having 600 plus libraries and 120,000 functions. It is very popular with startup companies, okay, and increasingly so in the large organization. Then IBM SPSS. IBM SPSS Modeler is an industry leading data mining platform. Okay, it offers a powerful set of tools and algorithm for most popular data mining capabilities. It has colorful GUI, as I showed you in the previous thing. Okay, and colorful GUI format with the drag and drop capabilities. It can accept data in multiple formats, including reading Excel files directly. Okay, all these are the tools. Then ERP systems include some data analytics capabilities too. So SAP has its own business objects that we called as BO software. BO is considered one of the leading business intelligence suits in the industry. Okay. And it is often used by the SAP itself. Okay, so these are the some of the tools in data mining platform. So I stop here. Thank you so much.
You are now muted.